Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello everyone, this is Ashima Shukla, your current affairs and banking awareness faculty on Entry platform. And in this video, we are going to talk about all the major news events that have taken place in the past days. The discussion is going to involve all the major news events which are important from examination point of view, and we are going to talk about them in a short and crisp theory format, so that you cover all the major updates for your exam preparation and you can update your notes. For those who want to practice questions, we have 3 months live session going on at 4 p.m. on Entry Banking app, on the Entry Banking platform, YouTube channel. Whereas you can also find daily practice questions of current affairs that you can get on Entry app from the link provided in the description section below. Now, starting on the discussion of current affairs, the first is interest rate on the small savings schemes. They have been unchanged. Recently, they were revised. Government of India's Ministry of Finance, Department of Economic Affairs, they have retained the interest rate on small savings schemes. So, for the financial year 22, what are the interest rates for post office saving account? It is 4%. 5-year post office RD or recurring deposit 5.8%, post office time deposit or TD account 1 year 5.5%, 2 years 5.5%, 3 years again the same 5.5%. Then for 5 years it is 6.7%, post office monthly income scheme account that is 6.6% interest rate, senior citizen savings scheme is 7.4%, 15-year PPF or a public provident fund account is at 7.1% interest rate, national savings certificates at 6.8%, Kisan Vikas Patras at 6.9% and Sukanya Samriddhi account at 7.6% have been retained. These are very important for banking examination because individually for any of these interest, for any of these savings account they can ask you. Also, they can ask you that which state had the maximum small savings account in this year. That is going to be the state of Uttar Pradesh. That can, so West Bengal, that can also be asked. Then we have a few one-liners. China has announced a 5-year roadmap to achieve its goal of becoming global robotics innovation hub by the year 2025. Its aim is to achieve this by focusing on enhancements in key areas like control panels and servo motors. That is how they are planning it. And their ministry has revealed the operating income from China's robotic industry, which is expected to grow by around 20% per year between 2021 to 2025. Pankaj Sharma ji was appointed as the next ambassador of India to Mexico. Indo-Tibetan Police Force or ITBP Director General Sanjay Arora ji will hold the additional charge of SSP or Sashastra Seema Bal. All India Coordinated Research Project or AICRP on poultry breeding manatee under Kerala Veterinary and Animal Science University has bagged the National Breed Conservation Award for the year 2021 recently. The centre received this award from ICAR, the National Bureau on Animal Genetics Resource, for conservation and research activities on Telicherry breed, the only registered native chicken breed from Kerala. Then we have literary critic S. Nagabhushan ji, who was awarded the Kendra Sahitya Academy Award for his work Gandhi Kathan, the biography of Mahatma Gandhi ji. Then apart from that, Besu Bevi Gidad had won the Bal Sahitya Puraskar for the children's novel Odi Hoda Hudagan, and Lakshmi Narayan Swami was awarded Sahitya Academy Yuva Puraskar for his poetry Togala Chilanda Karna. Vinay Kumar Tripathi was appointed as the new chairman and chief executive officer of the Railway Board recently. Abdullah Hamdok has announced his resignation as from the position of the Prime Minister of Sudan. Mohideen Hussain Robel has recently resigned from the post of Prime Minister of Somalia. Reliance New Energy Solar Limited has acquired 100% shareholding in Faradon Limited with a total value of British pound sterling at 94.42 million based on an enterprise value of euro 100 million. Kishore Kumar Yedam was conferred with the World CEO Winner of the Year 2021 award. The water taxi service will soon commence in Mumbai in January 2022. It is going to offer connectivity between domestic cruise terminal at Ferry Wharf and terminals at Balapur and Nirol. Nippon Life India Asset Management, which is an asset manager at Nippon India Mutual Fund, has launched Nippon India Nifty Auto ETF. The offer for the new fund will be open from 5th of January and the minimum amount of investment is going to be 1,000 and investors can add 1 rupee after that. It's basically an open-ended scheme which will replicate the Nifty Auto Index. Kalpana Chawla Research Center for Center for Research in Space Science and Technology was inaugurated at the Union Defence Minister Rajnath Singh ji. It was established at the Chandigarh University in Gharwan. The Research Space Center is the first of its kind in North India, was launched at the Chandigarh University's Defence Scholarship Scheme worth 10 crore rupees. This Chandigarh University's Defence Scholarship Scheme is framed for the wards of defence personnel who are serving in any of the three forces. Reserve Bank of India has approved Fino Payments Bank to commence international remittance business recently. Therefore, Fino Payments Bank will be able to perform the inwards cross-border money transfer activities. Rohit Kumar, the founder of Media Trends, was honored with the Bihar Vibhuti Samman at the Bihar Entrepreneurship Conclave. V.S. Pathania was appointed as 24th Director General of Indian Coast Guard. S. Sahu was appointed as a panel head of the Primary Market Advisory Committee on Data set up by SEBI or Securities and Exchange Board of India. Tarun Kapoor was appointed as the head of Energy Transition Advisory Committee, which is set up by the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. GST Council's 46th meeting was chaired recently by the Union Finance and Corporate Affairs Minister Nirmala Sitharaman ji in New Delhi, in which the discussion on the change of rates in textiles took place. Now, after that, the existing GST rate of 5% instead of 12% would be continuing. Therefore, now the interest rates on textile, the GST rates is going to be continued at 5%. France will be holding the European Union presidency for the next 6 months till 30th of June under the motto Recovery, Strength and Belonging. Tech Mahindra is going to acquire 100% stake in Alice India and Green Investments with a total cost of up to $125 million. Union Defence Minister Rajnath Singh ji virtually inaugurated 24 bridges and 3 roads which are developed by Border Roads Organisation in 4 states and 2 UTs. Bridges are constructed in Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. Roads are constructed in Ladakh and in West Bengal. With this, we'll be winding up this segment and I hope this session has been helpful. We'll be seeing you in the next session. Till then, have a great day ahead.